Okay, so we'll continue our discussion on relationship between different economic variables given a quantification or through different methods, graph or the mathematical equation. So if you remember in the last class, we have started discussion about the derivative of various function, how to solve the various function. Then we introduced the optimization technique where we did two type of optimization. One is the maximization of revenue or maximization of profit. And second one is the maximization of the revenue or maximization of the profit, and second one is the minimization of the cost. So whenever we are doing this optimization technique, either it is a maximization or it's a minimization problem, we did not consider the case of a constraint and we just optimize the maximization of a profit function or we just optimize the minimization of a cost function. So today we will discuss the optimization technique with a constraint, either in the form of the income or in the form of the cost when it comes to cost and when it comes to the revenue, either it's maximization or it's a minimization of the cost. So in case of constraint optimization, this is a technique used for achieving a target under constraint situation or condition is called constraint optimization. So maybe the motivation for optimization is remain same, it is achieving a target either to maximize the profit or to minimize the cost. But here the difference is that there is a constraint along with the objective function. And how to do this constraint optimization? We generally discuss two type of technology. We'll talk about the substitution technique and later on we'll take the Lagrangian multiplier method. So taking the substitution technique, it can be applied to the problem of profit maximization or it can be for the cost minimization. For a profit maximization, one of the variables express in terms of the other variables and solve the constraint equation for obtaining the value of one variable. Suppose there are two variables x and y. So the best way for solving it through the substitution technique is represent one variable with the other variable and then you solve for that variable and finally you substitute the value of one variable in term of what you have solved to the other variable. And here the value which obtained is substituted in the objective function which is maximize or solve for obtaining the value of the other variables. So whatever the value is obtained by substituted, it will be again substituted back in the objective function which is maximize and solve for obtaining the value for the other variable. So we'll see how we use this substitution technique in case of a profit optimization problem and in case of a cost minimization. And how this is different for cost minimization? Maybe the method again remains same. The constraint equation is expressed in term of any one of these two goods of the variables and the equation is obtained from step one is substituted in the objective function. So whether it's a cost function, whether it's a profit function, the basic rule for the substitution technique is that we express one variable in term of the other variables, we get the value of one variable and finally again substitute back to the objective function. So we'll just take an example how generally we do the constraint optimization along with the constraint with the objective function, whether the objective function is the profit maximization or whether the objective function is the cost minimization. So we'll take a case of profit maximization first, and in case of profit maximization, we'll maximize the profit. So here profit is equal to 100x minus 2x square minus xy plus 180y minus 4y square. Okay. This is the profit function. And the profit here the optimization problem is the profit maximization. Since we are saying that this is the case of a constraint optimization, there is also a constraint attached to this. And the constraint is in the form of x plus y is equal to 30. So now what is the optimization problem? The optimization problem is maximization of profit function with respect to the constraint, that is x plus y, which is equal to 30. Okay. Now, how we'll do this? The first step is we'll express x in term of y, or we can express y in term of x. Okay, and after the getting the value of x or y, again we'll substitute this value of x and y in the profit function. Okay, so now we'll see. Let's substitute the value of x and y before it converting into the another term or maybe the profit maximization problem. So suppose x plus y is equal to 30. So this can be rewritten as x is equal to 30 minus y. So in this case, x we are representing in term of y, or y can be 30 minus x. So substituting the value of x and y in the profit equation, what we can get? Pi is equal to 100. It was 100x, so x we are representing in term of y, so this is 30 minus y plus 2. 30 minus y square, because it was 2x square, minus 30 minus y because it was xy, plus 180y minus 4y square. So if you look at the profit function now, all the terms in term of y, there is no x over here in the case of the profit function. Now again, if you'll simplify this, then this comes to 1200 plus 170y minus 5y square. Okay, so what we did, the first step is this, where we represent x in term of y. Now substituting the value of x in the form of y in the profit equation, which gives the profit equation, which is equal to 1200 plus 170y plus minus 5y square. Now to find out the value of y, what we have to do, we have to take the derivative of pi with respect to y, and which we need to set equal to 0. Okay, so if you are taking this, then this comes as the first order derivative, because for any maximization minimization rule, in order to get the value, always the first order derivative has to be equal to 0. So del pi by del y is equal to 0, which is like 1200 plus 170y minus 5y square, which is equal to 0. Now solving this, this will give you 170 minus 10y, which is equal to 0, or maybe minus 10y is equal to minus 170 and y is equal to 17. Now what is our x? X is equal to 30 minus y, so this is equal to 30 minus 17, which is equal to 13. So we get a value y which is equal to 17, we get a value of x which is equal to 13. Now putting the value of y and x in our profit equation, we get profit which is equal to 2800. So here how we maximize the profit with respect to a cost constant or with respect to a value of x and y? The first step is always to represent one variable in term of the other variable. So in this case, what we did, we represented x in term of y, and after represent the value of one variable in term of the other variables, then we put the value in the objective function. So if you remember in the previous slide what I was showing, that we represent the profit function only in term of variable y, then after getting the profit function, we took the first order derivative equal to 0 in order to get the value of y, and through that we got the value of y which is equal to 17, and from there we got the value of x which is equal to 13. Now putting the value of x and y in the original profit function, we get a profit which is equal to 2800. Okay, so by substitution technique, following the two step, we got the profit, we got the value of x, and we got the value of y. Now we'll see through substitution technique how we can do a cost minimization problem. So here, what is the optimization problem? The optimization problem is to minimization of the total cost. Now what is total cost? Let's take total cost is equal to 2x square minus xy plus 3y square. Okay. Now the form here, what is the constant? The form has to get a 36 units of x and y as the combined order. Okay. Now what is the optimum combination? Optimum combination is to what should be the minimum cost to produce this 36 unit of x and y. So in this case, what should be the constant? The constant is, again, if you look at x plus y is equal to 36. So optimization problem is to minimize the total cost with respect to, or maybe subject to, x plus y is equal to 36. Now following the substitution technique, what is the first step? The first stage, we have to represent one variable in term of the other variable. Okay. So x is equal to 36 minus y. Because if you remember, the first step of substitution technique is always representing one variable in term of the other variable. So here x is equal to 36 minus y. Now putting the value of x in the cost equation, 2x square, so this is 236 minus y square, x and y, so this is 36 minus y plus 3y square, so this is 3y square. So if you again simplify this, this comes to 2592 minus 180y plus 6y square. Okay. So after putting the value of x in the cost function in term of y, we get a total cost function which is equal to 2592 180y plus 6y square. Now in order to get the value of y, and in order to get the optimum combination or the optimum cost, what we have to do? We have to take the first order derivative of total cost function with respect to y, and we have to set it equal to 0 in order to get the value of y. So now we have to take a derivative, the first order derivative of 2592 minus 180y plus 6y square, and this has to be equal to 0. Okay. So if you do this, then we get the value 180 plus 12y, which is equal to 0, which you further simplify, then it is minus 12y is equal to minus 180, and y is equal to 15. Okay. And if y is equal to 15, then x is equal to 36 minus y, which is equal to 21. So y is equal to 15, x is equal to 21. Now this is the optimum combination. The form should produce 15 unit of y and 21 unit of x, and this is the optimum combination for the form. Now what is the next best task for us? The next best task for us is to, whether producing this combination, the form is incurring the minimum cost of production or not, or what should be the minimum cost to produce this combination. So for that, what we need to do, we need to put the value of y, we need to put the value of x in the cost equation, and we need to find out the minimum cost. So what was your cost equation? The cost equation is 2x square minus xy plus 3y square. So putting the value of x is equal to 21 and y is equal to 15, this comes to 882 minus 315 plus 675, which is equal to 1242. So this is the minimum cost what the farm incurs in order to produce 15 unit of Y and 21 unit of X. So what is the optimization problem here? The optimization problem here is to minimize the cost with a constant that at any cost the farm has to produce 36 unit of both the goods, that is X and Y. So this is the optimum combination for the farm, and this is the minimum cost to produce the optimum combination of the farm. Next we'll see the second method too for this constant optimization, and that is the Lagrangian multiplier method. So apart from substitution technique, the most popular or maybe the most commonly used technique to do a constant optimization is always a Lagrangian multiplier method. So what is Lagrangian multiplier method? It is again one of kind of method to solve the constant optimization, and it involves combining of both the objective function and the constant equation and solving by using the partial derivative methods. Basically, it takes the partial derivative with respect to both the variables, and then it gets the value of X and Y, and by getting the value of X and Y, it maximizes the profit or minimizes the cost. So we'll see how it works for the Lagrangian methods. Let's take a profit maximization case. Okay. Suppose the profit equation is 100x minus 2x square minus xy plus 180y minus 4y square. Okay. Again, subject to x plus y is equal to 30. The same profit equation what we took for the substitution technique, and the same constant what we took for by using the substitution technique method. So x plus y is 30, that is constant, and profit is what we take for the substitution method. Now how it is different from the other method? In case of other method, we are substituting the value of x and x for y or y for x. Here we'll not do that, rather we'll use a partial derivative method to solve this profit maximization problem. Okay. In this case, what we do? So x plus y is equal to 30. So we'll find another variable here, that is x plus y minus 30 is equal to 0, and lambda x plus y minus 30. Okay. Now we'll reframe the objective function using the adding a Lagrangian multiplier over here. And what is the Lagrangian multiplier here? That is lambda x plus y minus 30. This is the another term what we are getting here. So what is our new profit function? New profit function is 100x minus 2x square minus xy plus 180y minus 4y square. This is our original profit function. Along with that, we add a Lagrangian multiplier, that is lambda x plus y minus 30. Okay. So if you look at now the constant also we have added in the objective function. So this is our Lagrangian function. Lagrangian function comes from the constant and what we add in the objective function in order to maximize the profit. Now this is the profit function. Now we have to find out the value of unknowns over here. What are the unknowns over here? The unknown is x, the unknown is y, and the unknown is lambda. Okay. So we need to solve for the value of x, we need to solve for the value of y, we need to solve for the value of lambda. Now how we'll do that? We'll take a partial derivative of the profit function with respect to x, we'll take a partial derivative with respect to profit with respect to y, and we'll take a partial derivative with respect to lambda, which is the Lagrangian function, or which one is the Lagrangian multiplier. So we'll take the first one, that is L, maybe first order derivative of this with respect to x. So this will get as 100 minus 4x minus y plus lambda, which is equal to 0. And let's call it the equation 1. Similarly, for the second one, we have to take the derivative with respect to y. So this comes as lambda, this as x plus 180 minus 8y plus lambda, which is equal to 0, and this is equation 2. The third unknown is with respect to lambda, so this is del l pi with respect to lambda, that gives you x plus y minus 30, and this is equation 3. Okay. Now if you make a summation and if you can make a two equation, then it comes to 100 minus 4x minus y plus lambda is equal to 0. And if you add the second two equation, this is 180 minus x minus 8y plus lambda is equal to 0. So if you do a subtraction from 1 to 2 over here, then you would get minus 80 minus 3x plus 7y plus 0, which is equal to 0. So if you look at what we did over here, we basically, in order to get the value of x and y, we got two equation, maybe two joint equation, in order to get the value of the unknown. So in the first case, this is 100 minus 4x minus y plus lambda, and second case it is 180 minus x minus 8y plus lambda, which is equal to 0. If you subtract the second one from the first one, we get minus 80 minus 3x plus 7y plus 0, which is equal to 0. Now if you look at the equation 3, x plus y minus 30, this is our equation 3. We'll multiply 3 with this equation. Okay, so this is x plus y minus 30, which is equal to 0. So if you multiply 3 in equation 3, this comes to 3x plus 3y minus 90 equal to 0. And what was your previous equation when we did for this? This is minus 3x plus 7y and minus 80. And if you take this again, this comes to minus 3x plus 7y minus 80, which is equal to 0. From these two equations, if you sum it, then it comes to 10y minus 170, which is equal to 0, and y is equal to 17. Okay. So we got the first unknown value, that is y is equal to 17. Now we can get the value of x from here, because x plus y is equal to 30, right? So from that we can get the value x, which is equal to 13. And now we can get a value from the, so this is our first unknown, this is our second unknown. Our third unknown is lambda. So from the value of x and y, we can get the value of lambda, and lambda will come to minus 31. So we know the value of all these three unknown. Once we put it in the value in the profit equation, we get the profit, and we can see whether the profit is maximum or not. Similarly, using this Lagrangian method, we can also solve a cost minimization problem, where the optimization problem is to minimize the cost. So let's look at to the cost minimization problem. Now the cost function over here is 100x square plus 150y square, and this is subject to x plus y, which is equal to 500. Okay. Now, Lagrangian method, what is the first step? The first step is to get the Lagrangian function from the constant equation, then again form a cost function adding the Lagrangian multiplier or the Lagrangian function. So in this case, the Lagrangian function is lambda 500 minus x minus y. So this is our Lagrangian function. Taking this, what is our Lagrangian cost function? That is 100x square plus 150y square plus lambda 500 minus x minus y. Okay. So if you look at now, how we have again three unknowns, that is x, y and lambda. In order to find that, what we'll do, we'll follow the same maybe formula what we did for the profit maximization. We'll find out del LC with respect to x, we'll find out del LC with respect to y, and we'll find out the del LC with respect to lambda. Okay. And after getting the equation, again we can get the value of x as 1.5 y, so that comes to y is equal to 200 and x is equal to 300, and from there we can get the value of the cost and we can get the value of the Lagrangian multiplier. Okay. So what is the essential difference between the substitution technique and the Lagrangian technique? We use both the methods to solve the constant optimization problem. And what is a constant optimization problem? A constant optimization problem is one where we maximize the profit function or the minimize the cost function with a constant that is in the form of the other variable. So in case of substitution technique, what we do, we substitute the, we represent the value of one variable in term of the other variables, and then we substitute that value in term of the other variables in the objective function, whether it's a profit function or whether it's a cost function. Then we solve for it, and we get, when we get one value, we represent that in term of others and get the final value of the other variable also. And in case of Lagrangian multiplier method, we form a Lagrangian function on the basis of a constant, add that to our objective function and solve the objective function through the partial derivative method in order to know the value of unknowns. And what are the unknowns over here? Unknowns always in term of the variable, two variable, those are in the objective function, here typically in the case of the x and y. So we started our discussion for this typical topic, we started our discussion with the relationship between different variables, whether it's linear, linear, maybe non-linear or curvilinear. Then we discussed different function attached to different kind of function, linear, non-linear and the curvilinear. Then we discussed the method of how to solve the different functions, and then we talked about the optimization problem where we maximize the profit and when we minimize the cost. And today's class we have talked about the optimization with a constant using both the method, that is Lagrangian method and the substitution technique.